So I think from a co-founder or founder's perspective or entrepreneur's perspective, I think the risk involved in a VC is that a VC can drive you off your model. He can take charge in the sense that he can't take charge of the company. He can take charge of your vision. All right. I have seen cases, I will not get into specifics, that where VCs have forced a founder to grow much faster than what he thought was possible. And as a result, there has been disruption. Back end has not caught up. There are issues, but they want growth at any cost. Sometimes VCs are raising another fund. They want you to perform. So you can actually become a circus monkey for a VC unless you are careful. You can serve his needs more than he'll serve yours. So there are VCs that are more long term. Like typically people like Accel, Sequoia, they think in terms of decades, 10 years, 15 years. They are very long term funds. So one thing to look for is that when is his fund ending? What is the duration of his fund? So if he's investing from a fund that is getting over in 2 or 3 years, you can expect the pressure to come on you to show growth. But if he's got a fund that is just closed and got 7, 8 years left, then he will pretty much leave you alone, because until he completes 5 or 6 years, he's not going to start raising another fund. So that helps to know at what stage is he in his own fund. All right. So that is one thing. So that is when, so VCs don't take, I mean, to be fair to venture capital investment investors, they're not doing it out of spite or anything else, right? They're doing it because they need to. They're in a situation where they need to show to their investors they're doing well. So then who's at hand? The founder is at hand. So they'll make him push harder. No, you got to do this. You got to show growth. I need so much. I need this and that. And sometimes if the founder is not strong, he'll compromise himself, right? Most times founders, even not wanting to, will go along saying, okay, if he wants it, it's his money. You know that sometimes, and Indians also tend to be a little accommodative, a little too accommodative sometimes. Nahi, theek hai, investor hai, his money, he has the right. No, he doesn't have the right. He backed you, remember? He backed your vision. But then if you push back and if the relationship deteriorates, it's not a healthy thing also. So it's kind of a tough thing. But I think what will help a founder most is to ask the right question. Is to which is the fund? When is it closing? You know, how many years have you got? Where are you in that cycle? So that will tell you how much pressure is going to come on you or not. Is there's a single one indicator that will tell you whether you are in the right company or not. Remember, for a VC, you are one of his 25 investments, right? As a founder. But for a founder, he's all you've got. So it's kind of a strange relationship. You know, if he raises a large enough fund, tomorrow you go bust, he doesn't care. Not he doesn't care, but he's got other irons in the fire, right? He's going to get his money somewhere or the other. You're not the only one, but he'll push you to raise so that you can show the numbers, you can raise another fund.